thinking of marrying a Sufi.
As somebody who practices a Sufism.
So, okay.
And we do not know very much about it, so what kind of advice?
Because she keeps on saying that it's spiritualism and that all they want is love,
Love people. One second. Are you talking about a man who is Sufi or the sister is Sufi?
The man.
The man is Sufi. Wanted to marry a sister?
Sufi.
Do you know the sister?
Yes, our very good friend.
Okay, so she's not here now?
No.
Okay. So a sister who is Sunni, you mentioned, and someone who is Sufi wanted to marry her. So we need to ask the question, what do you mean by Sufi?
Exactly.
If we mean by Sufi those people who believes Allah is everywhere, and Allah will be in the souls of the people, or be in the bodies of the saints, or they believe they go to the graves and ask the people of the graves, and they believe the people of the grave benefits and harm, those they have major shirk. And that's major shirk could take them out of the fold of Islam, al-'iyadu billah. So that's why.
But she's saying this person doesn't do none of this, all he wants to
do. You don't have to do things. We all love Islam, let me tell you something. We love Allah Azza wa Jalla, we love the believers, but it doesn't mean we identify ourselves as this. The old Sufis in the beginning, they were upon the haqq, they were upon the truth. They were about zuhud. Zuhud means neglecting the worldly temptation and just focus on ibadah and akhirah. That's fine. And those are the early ones. Like, for example, Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, rahimahullah, one of the great scholars as well of Islam and one of the great scholars of Ahl Sunnah. Yeah? And the same thing, Abdullah ibn Adam, many of the scholars of Islam, those are great scholars of Islam, and they follow the guidance of Islam. And they follow the guidance of Allah and His Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. You may have some kind of, maybe some shortcoming from some of them, but it's in the same time, overall, there were people who are devoted to Islam and they follow Islam to the best of their ability. The problem is, when people came after, they start imposing things, they start adding things to Islam. So when these things added, they say it's more spirituality. Islam is not about just only spirituality, sorry to say. Islam, it has spiritual aspect, and it has as well action, and as well it has some kind of actions as well we have to do. We have to pray five times a day, we have to fast the month of Ramadan. We have to do certain things.
She said that he's doing all of that.
Yeah, my point is as well, and as well Islam, is not identifying yourself as Sufi. As soon as a person identify himself as Sufi, that means he is isolating himself from the other Muslims. We'll ask, what's the difference? If you follow the Islam, we follow Islam as it is. This is what Islam is about. So we have to follow Islam as it is. And Islam, it has to be as follows. Quran, Sunnah, and understanding of the Sahaba and the Tabi'in and the Tabi'i Tabi'in. This is what Islam. Unfortunately, the Sufis, they agree with the Quran and Sunnah, but as well, they add other things later on. They say the Sahaba. What they do not agree, for example, the matters of Aqidah, the matters how we accept Aqidah. We accept Aqidah, the creed of Islam. We accept the creed of Islam is literally we take what is mentioned in the Quran, what's mentioned in the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, especially in relation to Allah's names and attributes. We take them as they are, yeah, without going into details. Meaning when Allah says in the Quran to Iblis, why don't you prostrate to what I have created with my two hands? So Allah confirms that he has two hands. How his two hands? We don't know. We keep the heart on Allah, and we say that those hands that befits His Majesty and glory, and that's it. The Sufis, they say, no, we don't discuss about these things. No, we just, Allah says, Allah didn't find it humiliation for him to say this in his Quran, in his book. So that's why we describe Allah what he has described himself. So we take it as it is, without going into details, without going into how and all of these things. Plus, as well, the simple question that gives you the identity to say, ask, where is Allah? Have you asked him, where is Allah? This question to ask this person, if you ask, where is Allah? If he says to you, Allah is everywhere, you should know that they commit a major shirk. Meaning, if you say Allah is everywhere, that means Allah in my stomach, a'udhu billah, wal'iyadhu billah. Is Allah in the toilet? That it doesn't befit Allah's glory and majesty, tabarakata. And Allah himself, tabarakata, he mentioned where he is. He said, Allah ar-Rahman al-Arsh istawa. Allah is upon his throne. He is above his throne, and he raised up above his throne. That's all. That's what we know. We don't know nothing beyond this. We take it as it is. So Allah above his throne. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to a slave woman, he said to her, where is Allah? She said, Allah in the heaven, like this. So who am I? She said, you are Muhammad, the Messenger of Allah. Then he said, free her because she is a true believer in Allah. So we believe Allah is in the heaven, meaning in the heaven, above the heavens. And the throne of Allah is above the heaven. And he is above his throne the way that befits his majesty and glory. That's how we believe. And we take it as it is without going into ambiguity and all of these details. We take it as it is. So unfortunately, then the nowadays, they don't have this kind of understanding. See, Allah is everywhere, these things, and that's not from Islam. Basically, this is not from the understanding of the Quran and the Sunnah and the Salaf. The Salaf means the pious predecessors, the Sahaba, the Tabi'een, and the Tabi'i Tabi'een. They did not understand like this. They understand Islam like this. They understand Islam. What Allah has revealed, they will take it as it is. Yeah? Like a man came to the Prophet ﷺ. They said, does Allah smile? Does he smile? Ask this question. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, yes, he smiled. So Allah, the Prophet ﷺ, he confirmed that Allah smiled. Then he said that we will be not prevented any khair, any goodness from a Lord who smiles. That means Allah is not who's angry and wanted to punish people. That means he smiled. And the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that Allah even laughed in a hadith that a husband and his wife, they invited a person to their house. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, who's going to take care of the guest of the Messenger of Allah? He said, I will take him, Messenger of Allah. They went, they have no food except for one person. What they have done, he told his wife to prepare the food. They put the food, they put it to the guest, and they switch off the light. They turn off the light. And then they start eating the food, which is only for one person. And they start pretending eating with him to show him that we're happy, we're eating all together. But they were not eating. They wanted to feed the guest. And then the Prophet of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Allah has smiled about your action yesterday. So that's the meaning. This is who Allah, who we believe in. You understand? So that's how we believe in Allah. So that's why, my sister, this is how we take Islam. This is the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the understanding of the three generations, the Sahaba, the Tabi'een, the Tabi'i Tabi'een. Is that clear, my sister? Yeah? Did I answer you?
They're trying to dissuade her from marrying him. Because exactly as you said, Sheikh.
Does she have a wali?
No.
She has a father.
But he doesn't know about it.
No, she has to go with the father. The wali is the father. It doesn't matter. We have to understand the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "La nikaha illa bi wali wa shahada." There is no valid nikah except the wali and two witnesses. So if the woman, her father is not there, or he's not Muslim, then in that case, the imam or someone who has authority in the community, in the Muslim community, he will be the one who is her wali. So she will choose someone to be her wali to give her in marriage.
A brother.
Huh?
A brother.
Yeah. Older brother. If her father is not there, her brother, etc.
So if she actually advised her to come to you, Sheikh, or somebody,
she was.
So
let her come to me.
So they can understand what is the difference.
Let her come to me. You advise and you live in Allah. You advise. What you do? You have nothing to do except the advice. You have to advise. That's what you can do, inshallah.
Would it be okay if he decided to leave the Sufism? You know,
if he says, you know, I follow the Quran and the Sunnah and the way of the Sahaba, alhamdulillah, what do you want from him?
That's fine. It's not too far.
And he changes to Sunnah.
If he believes Allah is everywhere, I don't see it's right.
It's a Sufi background, but I don't.
Someone believes Allah is everywhere, sister. It's someone
who
has major shirk. It's not small thing. It's not small. It's not small thing. It's a big thing.
So really, she's making a bad decision.
Yeah, it has to be clear from the beginning. He has to leave what he is upon and then to start fresh, and that's no problem. If he is ignorant, we'll teach him.
We don't know him.
If he knows and he is like this, that means he has issues.
We don't know.
All right. No problem, inshallah ta'ala. No problem, inshallah ta'ala. And as well, if you want, as well, you could take my number as well. If you want, she wanted to contact me.
Yeah,
let me write it for you, and then just text me your name, inshallah, later on.
Where are you from?
Jordan.
Oh, Jordan. Oh, mashallah.
And yourself?
London.
MashaAllah.
Bangladesh. Sheikh, if you could type your number. You're my favorite Sheikh.
JazakAllah khair.
Only very few Sheikh I listen to, and you're one of them.
JazakAllah khair, sister.
I don't know that.
Yeah, that's my number, Sheikh Muhammad. All right. JazakAllah khair. JazakAllah khair. JazakAllah khair. JazakAllah khair. JazakAllah khair.